Bonjour à tous, hello everyone, and welcome to Apprenons Ensemble. French for Beginners, Reading Comprehension 1, A2 level. Okay, this is a new type of topic that I would like to introduce, and this is how it will work. We'll be having a text, we are going to read it, and then we'll have some comprehension questions that we are going to answer. So if you like this type of topic, please, I would like you to mention it in the comment section. Yes, if you like it, and no, if you do not like it. So it will help me know if I need to introduce it for our Saturday's class. But before we begin today's class, I would like to mention that this channel is talking about anything related to learning French. So if you do like the content, I would like to ask you to please register, like, and hit the bell button under the video not to miss any new upload. It will really boost me and help me serve you better content. Okay, so we can start today's class. Read the following text. So we are going to read a text, and then after we'll be having some comprehension question. So lisez le texte suivant. So here is the text. Okay, so if you don't know how I'm going to read it, I will leave a link on top because we already studied this text, so we are not going to study it again. Okay, so I will leave a link below on top. Right corner of your screen, you can go and watch the video about how to be able to read this text in the better way. Okay, so I'm just going to read it. You can also follow me. You can just read it also. Okay, then after we'll start the question. But before we start, you can also pause the video and go get a pen and some things to write down, and then you can continue the video. So let's get started. Jour de la semaine. Le lundi, David reste toute la journée à l'école. Souvent, le soir, il pratique une activité musicale, le piano. Le mardi ressemble au lundi, sauf qu'il n'y a pas d'activité après l'école. David rentre chez lui pour faire ses devoirs et se reposer. Il y a des régions où les enfants ne vont pas à l'école le mercredi. David, lui, va à l'école le mercredi matin. Le mercredi après-midi, il se détend et va jouer au football dans son club. Le jeudi est comme le mardi. On ne fait qu'aller à l'école. Le vendredi, la classe dure toute la journée, mais elle est souvent plus courte pour laisser les élèves en week-end plus tôt. La journée est longue pour David qui attend le samedi toute la semaine. Le samedi, il dispute des matchs de football avec son club dans le cadre de compétitions régionales. Le dimanche, il se repose et en profite pour faire ses devoirs pour la semaine. C'est déjà le lundi et toute la semaine recommence. Ok, so please, you can pause the video here if you need more time for you to understand the meaning of the text. Okay, so first I would like you to take your time and try to get the meaning of the text. Okay, then after getting the meaning, you can continue the video. Answer the following questions. Répondez aux questions suivantes. Okay, so in this part, what are we going to do? We'll be having some questions. Okay, so we'll read the question. Okay, and we'll have some possible answers. So that's why you are going to use the paper and the pen. So you need to read the question, find the answer in the text, and choose between the possible answer that I'm going to give you. Okay, so we'll be having 10 seconds for each question. So if you think that 10 seconds is too less for you, you can pause the video, read properly the question, get the meaning of the question, go get the answer, and choose the convenient response from the given choice. Okay. So, we'll continue. So, question number one. Quelle activité David pratique-t-il le mercredi après-midi? One more time. Quelle activité David pratique-t-il le mercredi après-midi? Le tennis, le piano, le football, le violon. So, you have 10 seconds. Thank you. Okay. Question number two. Quel est le bon ordre pour les jours de la semaine? One more time. Quel est le bon ordre pour les jours de la semaine? Answer number 8. Mercredi, jeudi, dimanche, samedi, vendredi, lundi, mardi. B. Dimanche, lundi, jeudi, vendredi, samedi, mardi, mercredi. C. Lundi, mercredi, dimanche, jeudi, samedi, mardi, vendredi. D. Lundi, mardi, mercredi, jeudi, vendredi, samedi, dimanche. You have 10 seconds. Ok. Question number 3. Quels sont les deux jours du week-end? One more time. Quels sont les deux jours du week-end? A. Lundi et mardi. B. Samedi et dimanche. C. Vendredi et samedi. D. Mercredi et jeudi. You have 10 seconds. Ok. Question number 4. Quels sont les deux jours qui se ressemblent le plus pour David? One more time. Quels sont les deux jours qui se ressemblent le plus pour David? Answer A. Le samedi et le dimanche. B. Le mercredi et le lundi. C. Le vendredi et le dimanche. D. Le mardi et le jeudi. You have 10 seconds. Ok. Question number 5. Quel jour David passe-t-il le moins de temps à l'école? One more time. Quel jour David passe-t-il le moins de temps à l'école? A. Le lundi. B. Le mercredi. C. Le mardi. D. Le vendredi. 10 seconds. Okay. Now we are going to find the different answers. So, if you still need time to answer the question, please, you can pause the video, take your time, answer each question, okay? And then, now, after that one, you can come and then cross-check with your answers, okay? So, let's start. Question 1. Quelle activité David pratique-t-il le mercredi après-midi? Okay. What activity does David do on Wednesday afternoon? What activity does David do on Wednesday afternoon? Okay. So the answer will be somewhere here in the green part. Souvent, le soir, il pratique une activité musicale, le piano. So often in the evening, he practices a musical activity, the piano. Okay? So here, according to the possible answers, so the correct answer is C, le piano. Okay? Next one. Question 2. Quel est le bon ordre pour les jours de la semaine? So what is the right order for the days of the week? Okay. So the answer is somewhere here. C'est déjà le lundi et toute la semaine recommence. So it is already Monday and the whole week starts all over again. Okay, so that means the weeks there will be starting according to the calendar. The week will be starting on Monday. So the correct answer will be lundi, mardi, mercredi, jeudi, vendredi, samedi et dimanche. Okay. Third question. Quels sont les deux jours du week-end? Quels sont les deux jours du week-end? So what are the 2 days of the weekend? What are the 2 days of the weekend? So the answer is somewhere here. Le samedi, il dispute des matchs de foot avec son club dans le cadre de compétitions régionales. Le dimanche, il se repose et en profite pour faire ses devoirs pour la semaine. So on Saturday, he plays football games with his club in the regional competitions. On Sundays, he rests and takes opportunity to do his homework for the week. Okay? So the 2 days of the weekend will be are nothing but Saturday and Sunday. Okay? Fourth question. Quels sont les deux jours qui ressemblent le plus pour David? Quels sont les deux jours qui se ressemblent le plus pour David? So what are the two most similar days for David? What are the two most similar days for David? So here we can have two possibles. I underline, I put two sentences in color because let's read the first one, you'll understand. Le mardi ressemble au lundi, sauf qu'il n'a pas d'activité après l'école. David rentre chez lui pour faire ses devoirs et se reposer. What's the meaning? Tuesdays look like Mondays except there is no after-school activities. Okay? So the question is the most similar. Now let's read the second one. Le jeudi est comme le mardi, on ne fait qu'aller à l'école. So Thursdays are like Tuesdays, we just go to school. Okay? So if I need to choose the most similar, so I'm going to choose mardi et jeudi. Okay? Are we okay with this one? Not mercredi and lundi because here they both look like, but we do not have the same activities in the after school. We do not have the same after school activities. Okay? Are we getting this one? That's why I chose jeudi et mardi instead of mardi and lundi. Are we okay? Question number 5. Quel jour David passe-t-il le moins de temps à l'école? Quel jour David passe-t-il le moins de temps à l'école? What day does David spend the least time in school? What day does David spend the least time in school? Okay, so here also we have the same problem. So let's read the red one first. Le vendredi, la classe dure toute la journée, mais elle est souvent plus courte pour laisser les élèves en week-end plus tôt. So on Fridays, the class lasts all day, but it is often shorter to leave students on weekends earlier. Okay? So here, if the sentence wasn't there, then we could have chose this one because I say the class lasts all day. So all day. Now let's see the green one. David lui va à l'école le mercredi matin. So David goes to school on Wednesday mornings. So Wednesday, he goes to school only mornings. Okay, only in the morning time. Okay, but Friday, all day. Okay, so if I have to choose the day where he spends the least time in school, then I'm going to choose mercredi. Are we all okay with this one? Okay, so this is it for this part. So if you were able to get all the answers, then thumbs up and keep it up. If you were not able, nothing to worry about. Please just practice because practice makes learning to be perfect. So this is it for the today's class. Thank you for watching and see you soon for another video. Merci. Au revoir.